Hi everyone, I'm Laurencio, and in this video I'm going to talk about all Gundam games for the... Gundam Battle Assault is a fighting game. You know, like Mortal Kombat, or Tekken, that sort of fighting game, where you just fight one-on-one. You get 12 playable characters and go on with fighting. It's a simple game, you punch, kick and shoot lasers, but as simple as it is, it's a lot of fun. The controls and everything is smooth and just like it should be. The game, even if it's not content rich, it's very enjoyable. It's one of my favorite Gundam games. SD Gundam Force is another amazing Gundam game. It's a side-scroller beat-em-up. You play with three different characters that you can change mid-level, and each of the characters feels unique and has unique abilities. One can even fly. The game is great. It's a simple beat-em-up, but the three different characters make an enjoyable experience out of the game. Even if the game itself is very, very repetitive. You just beat up Small Fry and you have an occasional boss battle. SD Gundam G Generation Advance is a turn-based RPG. It seemed like a normal game for this genre. I haven't played very much of it, as it was in Japanese and my Nihongo skills aren't as sharp. But for RPG lovers who know Japanese, it might be an okay game. Gundam Seed Destiny is similar to the first game reviewed in this video, but it has more content. Now you have 24 playable characters, more locations to fight in, more game modes, like for example a challenge mode. But any mode consists on fighting anyway, so no matter how many modes you get, you still do the same stuff. But still, it's a great game, and one I would always return to for some quick button mashing. Mobile Suit Gundam Seed, Tomoto Kimi to Koto, is a visual novel. Meaning that it's text heavy. You choose what path your character should go, and unless you know Japanese, this game isn't for you. The story is only about Kira Yamato, so don't expect to play with multiple characters, or with any other character than Kira. But for those who know Japanese, there are even some battle sequences with text. If what I'm telling you sounds interesting, then go for it! Oh, and you have to know Japanese for this game. Okay, and the next two games aren't actually GBA games, but they are Famicom Mini ports. And while the first one, Scramble Wars, is a turn-based game that I found to be rather dull, the second one, Hot Scramble, is amazing. I mean, it has multiple gameplay elements, the controls feel great, the whole gameplay feels great actually. And remember that we are talking about a game that was released in 1986, which, even by today's standards, it's still a great game, which is amazing. Okay, so this was the video. If you liked it, please hit the like button and subscribe. And if you want, follow me on Twitch, Instagram or Discord. I left the links to those in the video description. Also, if you want to see another video of mine, just wait till I stop talking and there will be thumbnails of other videos I've made. Thanks for watching!